Dealing with the supernatural is always a challenge. But the most challenging case I ever received came from my longtime friend, Helen Hunter. She had gone with her assistant to Serpent Creek to report on the local festival. Stammering and sobbing, she asked for my help. It sounded serious enough. Before the call broke off, she said she had uncovered a horrible secret. I should find a room and begin my search first thing tomorrow morning. What is that thing? That was close. I need to get out of the car.
What? What happened? Who are you? A giant reptile creature. Have you been drinking? Oh, I'm sorry. That was rude. Thank you for your help. I'll explain later. Please, come in.
This van belongs to Helen's magazine. She has to be somewhere in town.
guest book's full, and it wouldn't interest you anyway. Sorry about before. Forgot to take my meds is all. What brings you to Serpent Creek, anyway? You're looking for someone. Helen Hunter. Nope, it doesn't ring a bell. Sorry. Let me fix you up with a room. It's the least I can do, right? Here, keys to room 8. You can check into your room. Sorry, but I'm busy at the moment.
Whoa, what is that?
Thank you.
What is this suitcase doing here? I must ask you to leave the room, now. It hasn't been serviced yet. Here, take this card and go for a walk or something. Take a tour around town. Don't come back until I'm finished with the room.
Who's there? Another tremor, this one even stronger than the last. So that's what the tremors were all about. What the devil is wrong with you?
Good evening. My name is Alistair Braminus, Mayor of Serpent Creek, at your service. As you are aware that we just experienced a minor underground tremor, nothing of concern, really. Unfortunately, I'm not able to reach Sheriff Wilson and inform him about the damages. Your friend went missing here. This is unexpected. Sheriff Wilson will be more than happy to help you. His office is down the street, across the town square. Now we need to find a way to reach the town square if we are to locate your missing friend. We need to get to town. Any ideas on how? We need to get to town. Any ideas on how to get across the rift in the ground?
Is that blood? Hey, what the?
I thought I saw someone back there.
What on earth happened here? Mm-hmm. Let's see what the evidence says. The perpetrator stands in the corner, occupied with something. Suddenly, he feels a pair of eyes at his back. The perpetrator rushes at the intruder. Adrenaline takes over, and he kills the intruder with a hammer. He then puts on gloves and drags the victim's body across the garage. The killer loses his balance and leans on the locker door. He pushes the door hard, leaving a dent. Then, the killer puts away the gloves, wipes away the evidence, and puts the ammonia bottle back on the shelf. He wipes down the murder tool, finishes his cigarette, and walks away. That means I scared off someone else. And the victim's body must be in the locker. I was right, and I recognize the victim. It's Joe, Helen's co-worker. These are Joe's keys. Let's see what's in that van outside the hotel.
What? A dead body? Goodness! This is truly shocking. You need to inform the sheriff immediately. Well done. You seem to be full of surprises. And I must make some arrangements. Please, make haste.
What is she doing? She doesn't look well.
Later, I need to tidy my stall and feed my lousy cat, Brebo. Come back,
yeah.
Sheriff, are you there? We have an emergency.
I can hear you snoring. Please, open the door. Open up, you drunkard. And fix your blasted doorbell.
This is not good. Sheriff Wilson is... He cannot hear me knocking.
What's worse? The doorbell is not working.
I need to contact the state police. Please, try to reach Sheriff Wilson on my behalf. I would be more than obliged. Now, if you'll excuse me... your help. If it weren't for you, I would have met my death most unwillingly. You must forgive me for not being able to repay you. Nevertheless, I still have to alarm the police about the dead body. You will do me a great favor if you try to contact the sheriff. After all, he is the authority in Serpent Creek.
Why can't you people just go to sleep like everyone else? The dead body in the garage? That's impossible. This is a small community, stranger. Things like that don't happen here. Ever. But if you're telling me it's still there, and the mayor crashed his car, is he okay? Earthquake? Well, we do experience some minor tremors once in a decade. Nothing to be concerned about. All right, I'm going to the garage to see if your story checks out. Guess I need to do something about that rift, too. Wait for me inside my office. I may need to ask you some questions later. Don't mind the snake. He won't mind you.
The sheriff wasn't joking. I'm not real fond of snakes. This should get its attention. Wow, look at it go!
My head. He is using the artifact. The eye. All of them. Every one. They can't hear. They can't speak. What are they digging for? I need my amulet. I need it. He took it from my neck. Does the sheriff know? His desk is so messy. Joe was right. I should never have stayed in that hotel. Please, my amulet. Find it. The rattlesnake took it. Amulet.
Why, good evening. Are you looking for something in particular? A guardian amulet? Yes, I do have those. But which one do you seek? Maybe if I had a picture of the amulet, I could see what you're looking for.
Sorry about before. You surprised me is all. You're welcome to use your room now. What do you mean I lied about Helen? Who are you really? I'm calling the sheriff. All right, no need to get violent. Listen, I'm not the bad guy here. Your friend, she came to town a week ago. Booked a room. She and another guy were writing some article or something. Day before yesterday, Wilson brought her in on a burglary charge. That's all I know, all right? Your room is ready. Now leave me alone.
Hello there. You must be my new neighbor. The name's Owen Duffer. How do you like the place? Strange, isn't it? Small town, crawling with snakes. The mayor says we've no need to fear the local reptiles. But who knows, right? My shirt, oops, looks like I must have caught it on something. Sure I've met Helen. Fine looking gal if you ask me. In jail? Well, ain't she a troublemaker? Off I go then. Maybe we'll grab a pint later.
What on earth happened here? Let's see what the evidence says. Someone opens the balcony window and steps inside. He trips over the long curtains, pulling them down. He gets up and leans on the wall, leaving a handprint. He looks under the lampshade. Behind the mirror, under the covers, and above the wardrobe. He tries to pull something out from under the wardrobe. There's a sound. Someone is coming. He trips over the chair. He knocks over the vase and gets away the same way he got in. I should try and get that photo from under the wardrobe. That must be the amulet Helen told me about.
Dear Guardian, I may have one similar to it. I can cut you a good deal. Let's say $50. It's a steal, I tell you. Not literally, mind your words. I bought it from Black, fair and square. Who are you calling thief? I don't like your tone of voice. Now scram, before Brebo rips your pretty eyes out. Along with your liver. I'm done. Now you've done it! Brebo, come back, you stupid cat! Curses! Curses on you!
I remember this. My guardian amulet. It's you, my dear friend. It's really you. Listen, there's something wrong with the people of Serpent Creek. There's a machine in the basement. It makes this buzzing noise. Drives them mad. There's a tall building, but he knows everything. He's seen me. Joe and I got a warning from a...
Behind you!
How did I get here? My head hurts.
Well, I'll be damned. I told you not to leave my office, but you didn't want to listen to the sheriff. Now, where's that woman? Did she lock you up in here? Damn it! I don't know what's going on in here, but if she's your friend, you should be more careful around her. She was locked up in here for a reason, you know.
Sheriff Wilson rang me about your little... accident. Your friend sounds very troubled indeed. I apologize if the sheriff was a little harsh with you. I'd like to thank you once again for saving my life. Here, I'm afraid this is the best I can do at the moment. Enjoy the last day of the festival.
Wait, is there someone inside?
Thank you.
didn't think I'd meet you here. You got a ticket from the mayor. Me too, it's, I know I've got it somewhere. Anyway, it was nice chatting with you. Cheers. Wait, did you do something to the main door? They won't open. There has to be something wrong with the mechanism again. Listen, I gotta get out of here. I'm not good with enclosed spaces. Especially ones with snakes everywhere. I'm gonna go upstairs and look for a way out. If you manage to find one, give me a shout.
Thousands of years ago, the snake god Gucamots reigned over the world. The people of Earth would seek him for counsel and protection, and he would save them from pain and fear. Gucamots was kind and caring. He loved all of his children. His brother, the shape-shifting god Season, was jealous of him. He wanted to be beloved as well. Season murdered Gucamots and took Gucamots' shape to reign over the humans. But he could not aid them the way his brother could. Gucamots' murdered body shed 3 tears before shattering into 1,000 pieces. Those 3 tears are the 3 seeds of life. Thousands of years.
It's getting away. I need to catch it.
Thank you.
Got you. Now give it back.
Is jammed. I also saw someone outside. I don't like this. Let's get out of here. Nicely done. You need to know something. I'm on an undercover mission. People started disappearing in London. Most of them were smugglers dealing in everything illegal. My employers discovered that there's a mysterious substance being shipped from Britain to the US. The shipment I was tracking ended up here in Serpent Creek. That's all I can tell you. Did you notice the light coming out from the lighthouse? There has to be an underground passage. I'll try to follow our mystery man. Stay vigilant. Thank you.
It's Helen.
Hold on, Helen. I'm coming.
The town looks pretty nice from up here. Wait a minute, was that a... It's the thing from before! It's hiding in the library. I should check it out. Someone locked the door from the inside. There's something outside. It's watching me. What on earth happened here? Let's see what the evidence says. The person dims the light bulbs. Odd. He's going through some geological maps. Eating whatever's inside that jar. When he hears someone entering the lounge, me. He throws his cane on the shelf, takes off his clothes, and climbs the bookshelves? How is it possible for him to fit in there? He rips out the vent cover and disappears in the vent? This is nuts. I need to check the vent.
Alright, this should be it, till the end of the year. Do I care what Branimus is doing with the owners of this stuff? Nope. Better them than me. Couple of hundred more and I'm out of this forsaken place. What? Hey, what are you doing here? You're that reporter. I'm not letting you spoil this for me. Not after what I've been through.
What is that thing?
Look who's crashed the wedding. Give me one reason why I shouldn't turn you in for burglary. Let me get this straight. A creature breaks into the library to read some books. Right. Keep out of the library before I lose my patience and send you to an asylum. Now get out!
Did you find anything? What? The hotel manager killed Joe? That reporter? No way. The cemetery? I think it's somewhere west from off the town square. I'd go with you, but someone needs to keep an eye on our sheriff, right? If you're gonna spy on Black, you're gonna need this. Hello again. I am looking for Mr. Black. Have you seen him? It appears he is elsewhere. If by some chance you run into him, please tell him I need to speak with him. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello? Is anyone there?
Listen, I want out. I don't know and I don't care what you're looking for in that old gold mine. Killing the mayor, putting the whole town under hypnosis, abducting tourists, holding up that reporter. This is too much. I'm done. Unlike you, I'm not a killer. Joe's death was an accident, and it's all your fault. I'll give you $5,000 if you'll just let me and the reporter go. Wait, what are you doing? No!
You have failed me for the last time.
Oh my! I think I've scared it away. My head is spinning.
Hello, little bird. I should put a bullet in your head and feed your body to the reptiles. No one would notice anyway. The only reason you're still alive, stranger, is that he's got plans for you. And your blonde friend. Enjoy your stay.
It's getting kind of messy, wouldn't you agree? With Black dead and the girl...
It doesn't matter. I finally got what I came here for.
Yeah, after 3 years of using the town for your dig in the old mines.
Careful now, Sheriff.
Or else what? You'll put me under the spell of your precious artifact? Is that it? I'm the one who keeps that machine running. I'm the one who's running this show.
And I'm the one who will reward you.
Really? Does that mean you can...
Patience, Sheriff. I will deal with you soon enough. Now, make sure no one tampers with the device.
These are Owen's files. The sheriff recommended killing him. What did he mean by pets?
the antidote. You must finish the antidote. You'll find the equipment inside. This is what I came here for. Take the gun. Be careful. It's still inside.
What on earth happened here? Let's see what the evidence says. Owen rushes in through the balcony door. He tries to barricade the door with a chair. A huge snake breaks in through the window. Owen fires at him. Owen manages to shake the snake off with a bat. He gets closer so he can finish off the beast. The reptile jumps Owen and pushes him off his feet. Owen shakes the creature off and throws it into the wardrobe. He's out of ammo. He reaches for his gun holster on the armchair, but the beast gets out before he can load the gun. The snake wraps itself around Owen and bites him fiercely. He fights the snake off for the third time, throws it into the wardrobe, and ties the belt around the door. Now I know how he got injured so badly. Let's see what's in that wardrobe.
This is bullocks. Listen, you need to stop this madness. Here is the key to the lighthouse I snatched when Wilson wasn't looking. You'll figure it out. Stop those evil bastards. Don't worry, I'll be all right. I just need to lay down here for a while.
Of research, millions of pounds invested, 3 years of digging through solid rock, all of this nearly destroyed by one person. You, it's high time for you to disappear, little pest, and your friend. Not over. Not by a long shot.
Hey, Wilson, stop.
Phew. That was close, sneaky bastard.
was one thrilling ride.
Bremenus, stop! You're not gonna get away with this!
Thank you.
alive!
You! So, my beloved twin snakes failed to stop you. No matter, I've already won. The seed of life is in my possession. My god's resurrection is at hand. Sizzin will reclaim the earth and kill your kind. But first, I shall feed on your flesh. You see, it's been a while since my last meal. The two of you will do just fine.
I'm so glad to see you. This'll make one heck of an article. The town seems to be back to normal again. Or at least almost normal. And the sheriff is going away for a long time. I'm just sorry about Joe and Black, I guess. They are still searching for the mayor's body. I hope he's gone for good. I guess we'll just have to wait and see.